ゃめにゃにゃじゅうにゃにゃとのにゃらびでにゃくにゃくいにゃにゃくにゃにゃはんにゃにゃじゃいにゃんにゃくにゃらべてにゃがにゃがめ。
You're listening to the Polly Price Podcast. Non-stop. Here's your host, the jack of all trades, Polly Price.
Hello, everyone. I am back.
I'm back, bitches.
That's right. The Polly Price Podcast is back online. And with a lot of people asking me, why the hell were we offline for so many freaking weeks? Well, actually, technically, I think it was about a month-long shutdown. But oh, do I have a story to tell you. The Polly Price Podcast was a victim of truthism. Just powerful people doing whatever they need to close their secret doors for the sake of their own sanity. And thousands of hard-earned money wasted on legal fees and other bullshit technicalities. With hours and hours and days and weeks wasted for the sake of someone's feelings. Now, I'm not going to name names because technically I can't, or else I'll get sued. So now that that's all behind us, I will use the name for this person from this moment forward given to me through a court order, and that's Mr. President. All right, folks, we have a great show lined up for you today. We're going to touch base with the oldest journalist on the planet, Mr. Kozmo. And I'm happy to announce that football is back, which means life can go on now. Well, at least for the players and staff, that is. So we'll be diving into the NFL later on. Plus, I have a new segment which I call, Hey, what's the word of the day? So I'll be giving you that one later as well. And you will get my movie and song of the day. So I'm excited. Kozmo, let's get the show rolling so I can get to rolling.
I'm glad you're back, Polly, but sorry to say things haven't changed too much since the last time we heard the news. Now close to 200,000 Americans have died from COVID-19-related causes. Protests and riots continue, not only in the U.S., but throughout the world. Things have gotten so bad in New York, Lott left his apartment in the city for his house in the Hamptons. However, his wife looked back and turned into a pillar of salt. Wildfires on the East Coast have turned the sky red. And you know the old adage, red sky at night, a sailor's delight. Red sky in morning, noon, afternoon, the next day, the next week, all the time, sailors take warning.
Well, first off, my thoughts and prayers go out to all those whose lives were compromised due to the wildfires. I honestly can't imagine having to deal with that. And I hope all those people find the righteous path. And I know it's tough right now, it's rough times we're heading into, but if you could head over to redcross.org and help those in need with disaster relief, it would mean a lot. And also, speaking of tragedy, this past week was the 19th year anniversary of 9/11, a tragic day here in New York City. And it was nice to see the lights up in memorial of the towers, as well as the virtual readouts, which was definitely a necessary event. If you want my personal opinion, I think 9/11 should be a national holiday. We shouldn't have to go to work or school. It should be a day of mourning, but also celebrating the remembrance of all the fallen heroes who put their lives in the line to save innocent people. You know, so that day will never be forgotten in history or even lost in translation. So I think making that a holiday would be really good, especially today, what's going on in the world. You know, we have a new normal. And I can definitely say it's not normal. Am I right about that, Kozmo?
The entertainment industry has suffered. Even Vegas's ubiquitous strip clubs are no more. Little Darlings tried to stay open, offering coronavirus-free dancers and nude hand sanitizer wrestling. It is now shuttered with a sign saying, Sorry, we're clothed.
Wait, what?
Polly, have you noticed that it's still hard to find paper towels even months after the lockdown? Well, the Polly Price News team investigated and uncovered the truth behind the missing paper towels. Was it indeed a vast conspiracy involving the New World Order? And why does Vladimir Putin want me to use a hand towel? Dun, dun, dun! Actually, there isn't much to say, really. The reason for the shortage is people keep hoarding them. Factories are set up to produce just a certain number. They cannot actually make more unless they expand operations, which they won't do until people stop hoarding them. Because we only really need a certain number of paper towels. Hoarding does not indicate increased demand. You know business 101, supply and demand. So that's it. That's the reason. Back to you, Polly Price.
Yeah, this whole hoarding shit is so unnecessary. You know, I like to say, if you don't need it, then leave it. Because it's just selfish. And those people should get with the program, because honestly, it makes me so sick. Goddamn, I'm so pissed off now, I have to take a commercial break. But when we get back, we will be talking entertainment and then sports, so stay tuned and force yourself to listen to an ad from our sponsors.
Did you know that in the state of New Jersey, a homeowner is not required to disclose if the house you want to buy is haunted by ghosts? Don't worry. Keller Williams Realtor Janine Goldblatt does know. Janine knows the questions that need to be asked. She'll find out if the home you want to buy has any open permits, make sure you are paying fair market value, and yes, even find out if the house is indeed haunted. Janine's philosophy is to simplify the process of buying and selling real estate for her clients and to work with their best interests in mind. Keller Williams Realtor Janine Goldblatt serves Central New Jersey using the latest technology to understand current market trends and utilizing the knowledge that comes from years of experience. Call Janine today at 347-228-6031. That number again is 347-228-6031. Your dream home awaits.
All right, we're back, and we're back with the apocalyptic chick. Yes, luxury retail Louis Vuitton is launching a plastic face shield for those who prefer to strut in the grocery store in designer wares for nearly and only $1,000. Yeah, you heard it right here. $1,000 for a PPE. Well, what I really want to know is, are we now supposed to wear white face masks after Labor Day? I don't know about that. Also in the entertainment biz, The Walking Dead is finally coming to an end. Yes, CNN reported a decision has been made to kill The Walking Dead flagship series. Finally. AMC announced last Wednesday that it's bringing the series to an end. The show is set to conclude after an expanded 24-episode, 11-season that will air over 2 years. It is expected that the series will end in 2022. Oh, wait. So, you mean to tell me that it's not ending until another two more long-ass coronavirus years? Shit, man. Well, sorry, folks. This information is irrelevant now, so I guess I'll pull it back up in another 2 years. And I have to say, if there's one show that jumped the shark, it's definitely The Walking Dead. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for your sports report.
Suggs with the chuck. DeMass with the catch. Puts it up for the win. He got it! Marcus DeMass!
End around. John Brown is going to look to pass. Looking for Allings! Got it! Touchdown Bills on a trick play to start things off.
Watson. Ovechkin put it right on a platter for him. Kuznetsov for Ovechkin. Drive! He scores!
Over in the NFL, the New York Jets lose to the Bills 27-17. The Bears defeat the Lions 27-23 in a really close game. The Washington football team declaws the Eagles 27-17, and the Saints march over Tom Brady and his bucket of tears. Oh, I'm sorry, I meant Buccaneers 34-23. Brady's first outing with the Buccaneers, not too great, 23 out of 36 with 239 passing yards, two touchdowns, but also two interceptions. Not a great start there, Brady. Tonight's Monday Night Football game is my New York Giants versus the Pittsburgh Steelers at 7:15 Eastern on ESPN. In baseball, the New York Yankees defeat the Orioles 3-1. The New York Mets lose to the Toronto Blue Jays 7-3. Cincinnati beats St. Louis 10-5. And the Kansas City Royals shut out the Pittsburgh Pirates 11-0. Oh wait, Pirates, Buccaneers losing? I'm seeing a pattern here, folks. In the standings in the American League, Tampa Bay Rays are in first place. With second place, you have the Toronto Blue Jays, and in third, the New York Yankees. In the National League, we got the Braves in first, Marlins in second, Phillies in third, with the Mets in fourth, and the Nationals in dead last. But I got to give it to the best team in baseball right now with the best record, and that's the LA Dodgers, 33-14 with percentage over 700. That's friggin' impressive. And over in the NHL East Finals, we have Tampa Bay wins Game 4, 4-1 against the New York Islanders. Game 5 is tomorrow night, where the Tampa Bay leads that series 3-1. Tonight in the West Finals, we have Game 5 with Dallas and Vegas at 8 p.m., where Dallas leads that series 3-1. And finally, over in the NBA, there are no games tonight, but tomorrow night, September 15th, we got the Heat versus the Celtics at 6:30, following the Nuggets versus the Clippers at 9 p.m., and you can watch those games on ESPN. And that's all the sports that fits the podcast. All right, so we're going to finish off the news segment with good news like I always do. I always like to stay positive. We hear so much nonsense in the news and not good stuff. So I really feel like it's inevitable that we need to show the world that there's good shit going on. So here it is.
Born in 1909, Private Lawrence Brooks served in the predominantly African-American 91st Engineering Battalion, which was stationed in New Guinea and then the Philippines during World War II. He is now recognized as the oldest known living U.S. veteran of World War II. Brooks turned 111 this month, and the World War II National Museum held a socially distant celebration for him. The Victory Bells sang several numbers for him while the Big Easy Wing performed a military flyover. As reported, the museum had hosted a national card drive for Brooks in hopes of receiving 500 to 1,000 birthday cards. They got almost 10,000. Brooks has five children, five stepchildren, 12 grandchildren, and 23 great-grandchildren. Happy birthday, Private Brooks, from the Pauly Price News Team.
Well, there you have it, folks, the good news on a silver platter, because we don't hide the good and don't spread the hate. And to be honest with you, I dig deep within links upon links to get these stories, because they're not easy to find. And, you know, I'll tell you, it is always worth the time. You know, especially to spread such positivity to our listeners, I think it's very important. All right, that's all the news for today, which means it is time for the movie of the day.
Crushing death in glory.
You made a mistake.
Pineapple Express is about a lazy court process clerk and stoner, Dale Denton, played by Rogan, who has only one reason to visit his equally lazy dealer, Saul Silver, played by James Franco, to purchase weed, specifically a rare new strain called Pineapple Express. But when Dale becomes the only witness to a murder by a crooked cop and the city's most dangerous drug lord, he panics and dumps his roach of Pineapple Express at the scene. Dale now has another reason to visit Saul, to find out if the weed is so rare it could be traced back to him. And it is. As Dale and Saul run for their lives, they quickly discover that they're not suffering from weed-fueled paranoia. Incredibly, the bad guys really are hot on their trail and trying to figure out the fastest way to kill them both. Directed by David Gordon Green and written by Seth Rogen, here is Pauly Price's movie pick of the day, Pineapple Express.
I want to meet your parents. I just can't. I have a job.
I just know they'll like you, that's all. You're great. And you're sexy. I just want them to see that.
You want them to see that I'm sexy?
Do. Who's that?
Oh my god!
Sale, let me in.
Come on up.
I witnessed a murder.
What?
I saw you.
Did they follow you here?
Let's get out of here. Get the snacks, food, two roll-ups.
We are going to hunt these guys down. Dale, Saul, we're going to kill them all.
This is so exciting.
Whoa. Come on.
No.
I think we should stay.
Why?
Because I'm in the dumpster already.
I fly like paper, get high like planes. If you catch me at the border, I go visit them and then. If you come on.
We're coming at you with everything we got. You are dead.
This is the dinner you invited me to.
That's why I'm here.
Are you high?
What? No, I'm not high.
You are high as a kite.
Thug life.
I wish skulls and bones. Sticks and stones and feeding bones. Running when we hit.
Angie, I'm calling because I love you. I'll do anything to make it work.
I want to marry you.
Oh, I made a mistake.
Can't
see! Go kick out the window, isn't that what they do? I think I pulled my groin! Get your foot out of there! You're listening to the Pauly Price Podcast. Here's your host, the jack of all trades, Pauly Price.
All right, we're back on the Pauly Price Podcast, and I hope you enjoyed my clip from the movie of the day, Pineapple Express. such a stoner movie, obviously. You know, it definitely is a classic. I'm going to put it up there with Half-Baked. I really love those two movies. They both had good weed jokes, and the danger and violence that was incorporated. It was just great film. If you haven't seen it yet, check it out. If you don't like weed, then you're not going to like weed movies. You're going to hate it. So that's on you right there. But yeah, one of my favorite weed movies is definitely Pineapple Express. All right, let's move over to my new segment, Compliments of WordGenius.com, and that's, hey, what's the word of the day? And today's word of the day is gonzo. Definition: of or associated with journalistic writing of exaggerated, subjective, and fictionalized style. Examples of gonzo in a sentence. The longtime columnist was known for his gonzo writing. That mural down the street is just gonzo. In fact, in Spanish, gonzo means goose or fool, but in Italian, gonzo means foolish. But gonzo was adapted into the English language to describe the wild style of journalism that was popularized in the 1970s. So there you have it, the word of the day is gonzo. All right, we're coming close to the end of the show, but before we do, let's reveal what year we're going to go back to on our Throwback Thursday show coming up in 3 days. So here we go. We're going back to the year 1945. All right, 75 years ago today, and it was actually the end of World War II. So this is going to be a really good show, but sadly, we are at the end of my show. But don't worry, we'll be back next week, and we'll also be back this Thursday with our Throwback Thursday show. So I'm going to give you my song of the day so you can take the song and sing it all day and curse me out later. But the reason why I picked the song, especially what's going on today, with all the summer of violence and the wildfires and just everything that's going on, it's hard to stay positive. But sometimes music can do that for us. So I'm going to put this right here, Bob Marley, Everything's Gonna Be All Right. Because you know what? Everything's gonna be all right. So this is Paulie Price signing off saying, stay safe, not stupid.